Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. The Lakers picked up the big win last night against the Phoenix Suns, a much needed win. And the breakout star, it was Cam Reddish, the newly appointed starter for the Lakers. That was all the buzz heading into the game. Once the Lakers released their starting lineup about 30 minutes before game time, it was revealed that Cam Reddish was taking Austin Reaves' spot in the starting lineup. And Cam responded in a big, big way, hitting 5 of 8 threes, including one that essentially was the dagger in the game to seal the win for the Lakers. And his length on the defensive end of the floor was noticeable. It was very helpful having that length to help shut off passing lanes. Rui Hachimura, who wound up with 4 steals, also did a really nice job in that area. It felt like the first game where we finally have seen the Lakers' wing depth really be a factor and a factor in a very big win. But is Reddish a starter to stay? Check out what LeBron James said after the game when asked about Cam Reddish, the game he had, and LeBron himself getting a little bit of retribution. LeBron said, "To all the naysayers and basketball savants that don't know nothing about basketball, telling me I should have shot that shot in Miami instead of passing to Cam Reddish, well, I did the same thing tonight because I trust my teammates and I make the right play every single time. Game ball goes to Cam Reddish for sure." Well, LeBron is not wrong. He did make that pass out to Cam Reddish, who indeed deserves the game ball against Miami. That pass that went to Reddish ended up in a missed shot. The Lakers lost the game, and LeBron and Reddish wound up getting plenty of criticism. LeBron for not taking the shot himself, and Reddish for not making the shot. This game, the Suns decided they were going to leave Cam Reddish open behind the three-point line, and he indeed made him pay. But should he stick in the starting lineup? You know, I've seen a lot of Cam Reddish fans out there saying that Cam really isn't a bad three-point shooter, that he actually shoots over 40% from corner three. Corner three, singular. One corner. There is, over the past few years, Cam Reddish has been a really good three-point shooter from one specific spot, and it is that left corner three that he was in when he hit the big, essentially the one that put the game away last night. So I don't look at that and say Cam Reddish is suddenly this great three-point shooter or anything like that, or somebody that the Lakers can depend upon night in, night out to give you solid three-point shooting, because he is so limited to statistically over the course of his career in terms of where he can be effective. Everywhere else, it's very much okay to leave Cam Reddish behind the three-point line. But he really did some great things defensively, again, especially dealing with a Suns team that likes to utilize Kevin Durant, as they should, quite a bit. His abilities on the wing and his abilities just being 6'8 and having the long wingspan and all of that was really, really useful for this Lakers team. So I think this worked so far. It also works in the sense that Austin Reaves and D'Angelo Russell stagger their minutes a little bit more. It allows the Lakers to be a little bit bigger. Now, unfortunately, that didn't help the Lakers out as much as we would have hoped on the glass. They still gave up 17 offensive rebounds to the Phoenix Suns, which is simply way, way, way too many. But Cam Reddish being on the floor and shifting Reaves to the bench unit did seem to work for this game. I do wonder, however, and I don't mean to rain on the Reddish parade here at all, because he played a hell of a game and he deserves a ton of credit, but Jared Vanderbilt, will he slide into that starting spot for the Lakers once he returns? Hopefully we'll get an update on him real soon here. Still dealing with heel bursitis and should be getting reevaluated sometime this weekend. So excited to hear there, but wouldn't shock me if we do see Jared Vanderbilt eventually take that spot from Cam Reddish. But give Cam all the credit in the world. I think for the time being, including tomorrow's game against the Portland Trailblazers, we should indeed see Cam Reddish get another spot in the starting lineup. I don't think in this situation, you have a guy that just got an opportunity to start. He took advantage of it a big, big way, helped you get arguably your biggest win of the season, probably your second biggest win of the season behind the win against the Clippers. You can't demote him at this point. You can't take away the starting job right now. Keep him in the starting lineup. Let Reaves get used to coming off the bench and doing his thing there, which, by the way, he excelled doing that, having the ball in his hands. D'Lo had plenty of time to have the ball in his hands too, with them staggered a little bit more. Let the team adapt to this. And then when Jared Vanderbilt comes back, we can figure out what's what in terms of whether or not Cam Reddish hangs on to that starting job. But kudos to Cam Reddish. Incredible, incredible game. Big moments for him, and great to see the bounce back after that rough miss shot against the Miami Heat. And LeBron James, of course, this time getting rewarded for trusting in his teammates. Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Should Cam Reddish stay in the starting lineup? And make sure you click that join button. Check out our YouTube membership program. Lots of cool perks for you here on the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, everybody. See ya. and stay safe.